Please accept my sincerest obeisances and my life as a servant of your servants. This year, throughout the world, in hundreds of temples, in thousands of homes, and in millions of hearts, the 50th anniversary, a great milestone in the success of your life's mission, your founding the International Society for Krishna Consciousness, is being celebrated. As I write this offering, I am sitting in a little storefront on the Lower East Side of New York City, in the place where 50 years ago, the seed of your lifelong aspiration became a tiny flowering bud, about to blossom and spread its fragrance across the world. Here, while gazing out of my window, I am listening to recordings of your memories of those beginning days. In your own words, you bring us back to 1922. When this friend, Mr. Malik, took me to Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Maharaj, he immediately asked me, "You are educated young boys. Why don't you take up Lord Chaitanya's message and preach in the Western world?" In the very first sight, he told me. After describing your lifetime in preparation to fulfill your Guru Maharaj's will and your historic voyage across the world on a cargo ship, you bring us with you to New York City in 1965. When I came to your country without any friend, without any means, practically just like a vagabond I came, but I had full faith that my Guru Maharaj is with me. You describe your hopes, struggles, and limitless compassion as you pass through one challenge after another. A Vrindavan sadhu, wearing the simplest saffron cloth and white plastic shoes, wandering alone, seeking to share the treasures of the spiritual world in New York City, the massive, ever-expanding capital of materialistic life. In the recording, you continue, "I was maintaining myself by selling these books for 1 year. In this way, by selling these books, I had only $200 and I dared to take one apartment and storefront. The storefront was $125 per month and the apartment was $75. I had only $200. So I advanced him $200. I did not know how to pay next month's rent. I started in 1966, lecturing in the storefront and living in that apartment in 26 Second Avenue. Then gradually, these American boys and girls began to come. I started my kirtan in Tompkins Square. More and more these young Americans, they came to me and things were organized. Then I registered this Krishna Consciousness Society under the Religious Act of New York and gradually people took interest. In this way, 5 or 6 students used to come." Srila Prabhupada, in your ecstatic love for Krishna, you see everything is Krishna's sacred property. Every living being is very dear to you. Still, through your own intimate words, we gain a glimpse into how especially dear ISKCON is to you. How especially dear to you are those early devotees who helped when you were practically alone. How especially dear to you for all time to come are devotees who endeavor to follow your teachings, encourage your devotees, and offer favorable service to your beloved society. We all have the opportunity to show our love for you by cooperating to serve your life's mission, ISKCON. As it passes through both euphoric celebrations and at times inconceivable heartbreaks and challenges, as I gaze out of my window into the clamor of New York City, I see people rushing about, desperately seeking relief from the onslaughts of conditioned life, or searching for anything that might bring them a trace of satisfaction. But as I remember you, my heart fills with hope and gratitude. In this lifetime, all that really matters is how we please you. You asked us to sincerely chant the names of God and follow Krishna's teachings. With tears of love, you appealed to us to assist to you in fulfilling the order of your Guru Maharaj by sharing the matchless gift of devotional service with each other and with everyone. Radhanath Swami.
Srila Prabhupada ki jai.